Hello, welcome to the Health In Show, an affiliate program of Homeopathy World Community. You've come to the right place to tune in and participate with your comments and questions. Love is the greatest healer of all. But sometimes, in order to change our emotions, we must take action in other spheres of our lives. We speak with experts in alternative and complementary health fields and hope you will benefit in some small or great way. Remember, you are wherever your thoughts are. Make sure your thoughts are where you want to be.
Good day, everyone. We're calling in to the Health In Show with our producer, Amnon Nissan of Nissan Communications, and Dr. Carlos Gonçalves from Portugal. And he's been all around the world studying and teaching, and we are really grateful to have him with us. And we're going to experience what it is to have different emotions in our lives and how that integrates and plays into homeopathy and how we deal with it. I also have healing and deep thoughts that I like to share, especially because everyone wants to be at their best and being introspective as I typically am, I send these waves out to you. So we're going to begin first with the introduction on the slides. And I want to welcome everyone who's come in at the very last moment. Judith, Dr. Bob, Michelle, and Connie in the chat, and anybody else who is out there listening, you can get on the chat just by going to Nissan Communications and putting your name in. You can call and speak to us at 919-518-9773 or call via Skype at Computers2K Voice. So the first slide is just our introduction about we're starting this month off December 1st, 2014. And hopefully on the right foot. And so I have, everybody knows the golden rule, do not do unto your neighbor as that you would not have them do unto you, or in a positive light, do unto others as you would like them to do unto you. So here we have committed the golden rule to memory, and everybody knows in every country, culture, religion, land, what that is. Now, Edwin Markham tells us, let us now commit it to life. And that means taking that intention or thought and putting it into action. Amnon is diligently reading that the HWC presentation is for educational purposes only, and do see your healthcare professional for any medical issues. Okay, and we're going to just review the rule of similars. The basic principle of homeopathy, which means that a substance that has the ability to induce particular symptoms in a healthy individual, so if you eat a toxin, like salmonella is rampant out there, also has the ability to cure any disease expressing those same symptoms. So whether it is a plant, mineral, animal, or a nosode, a disease matter, these can be highly effective in small, minimal doses. And we're going to introduce to you today Dr. Carlos Gonçalves, medical doctor, DI home practitioner, DHM, BSc, MSc, home med, PhD, and classical homeopath, and founder and medical director of the ISH Institute of Homeopathy. He was a teacher at the British Institute of Homeopathy since 2007 and the World Institute of Sensation Homeopathy, member of the British Homeopathic Medical Association and the World Medical Association, the World Organization of Natural Medicine, and representative of the Other Song Academy from India. And I assume he teaches this method in Portugal. I'd like to hear a little bit more about that. He also studied at the British Institute of Homeopathy with the famous Dr. Trevor Cook, former medical homeopath of Queen Elizabeth II. His graduate thesis was the discovery of a new homeopathic remedy, the saliva of the Komodo dragon. We're not going to learn about that today, but it sounds very interesting. For this discovery, he was awarded the Life Fellowship of the British Institute. He's got a master's and PhD at Cambridge International University in Spain and an MD and PhD in the Indian Board of Alternative Medicine. He has a degree in clinical nutrition, which is really high on our list today, and master in homeopathic medicine, the Other Song Academy, and Vis Vitalis Education. And we welcome him on screen with us live, and we're gonna get a big smile out of him no matter what happens today, because glitches always happen on when we're live.
Oh my God.
So I've introduced you, and now we're going to go through this PowerPoint and learn a case that really touched you and had a lot of meaning in your life. What would
okay.
you
Okay, Debbie, I want to thank you for your invitation, first of all. And I would like to thank you all the work you are doing for homeopathy worldwide. Harman should be very proud of you. Thank you, Debbie.
You're welcome. I must say, though, that I think homeopathy is my heart and soul, but I take in all the different kinds of therapies that are available, whether it's acupuncture, massage, heat, you know, temperature changes, getting into nature, breathing, pranayama, whatever it is, we all have different things that help us.
That's great. Hello, brothers and sisters. Thank you for coming. What I brought to you today was a video of a patient of mine. And I would like to share with you what this case receiving. I would like to share my experience on case receiving rather than case taking, because I say to my students is, do not try to be the medical doctor in the clinic. Let the patient guide you. Stay back. Just listen to what the patient has to say, and observe the beauty to see the remedy coming to you. So I would like to show you a video case, but technically it was not possible, unfortunately, and I'm trying to upload it to YouTube now, so you can try to see it. The beauty of receiving the patient. Just sit, relax, and let the patient talk. That is what I would like to share with you. The profession of homeopathy is very simple. As Dr. Rajan Shankaran says, be stupid, don't be smart. Just relax and be stupid and continue asking the stupid questions, and the patient will tell you the remedy. And the case that I brought to you, unfortunately you cannot see, the patient tells you the remedy instead, not only tells you the remedy, she got into trance and she'll become the remedy in front of you. And I have hundreds of cases like this. The main thing is to just sit down, relax, and let the patient talk. So if we can go to the PowerPoints, I could explain the case to you, and you can see on YouTube later, also with the follow-up. With the follow-up, you can see what the remedy, the real similimen, can do to anybody, because sometimes we, as homeopaths, and I tell this to my students, what level are we as homeopaths practicing? Sometimes we see symptoms, a lot of symptoms, and we prescribe on symptoms. And we go to repertory and just prescribe on symptoms. In this case, for example, if we can go ahead a little, the patient complaints are chronic. Yeah, she is a 46-year-old. She is a doctor. And she is chronic urinary infections since 15 years old. She also complains on fatigue, shortness of breath, lack of memory, snoring. She's very tired when climbing on stairs and walking on plane, and low memory retention. So if we can prescribe on symptoms, we can repertorize this and practice like allopathic doctor. So viewing these symptoms, we can think about remedies like zinc metallicum, for example, right? It should work
It should work.
for some time, for 1 week, for example, and that is palliation, what we call palliation. Okay? Or magnesium phosphate, for example, should also be a good remedy. But it will only work for a few time. But if we go deeper to the patient and we see the right simile, you can change his life forever. If you see the follow-up, you will see the complete difference of the patient. It looks 10 years old younger, 100% cured. But not only from symptoms, from herself. She's a completely different woman now. And we can see it. And as she says, it was like a bomb. It was like a bomb to me, taking this remedy. One single dose, no repetition. The potency, I can tell you, it was 10 mg, one single dose. And I have hundreds of cases like this recorded. And I can share with you what patients usually say to me. There are two people that say to me that it's like having an ecstasy. Taking this remedy is ecstasy, what they say. It's funny, this comment. So we can go to the PowerPoint, and I will try to explain you what patient is saying. Let me see if the upload is going on. Oh my God, 90 minutes ready. Okay. So the main question we should say, or we should ask to anyone, and you all know, is tell me about your problems. And the patient will talk about his problems. Let him talk. Don't interrupt. Okay? Another one? Another side, please. Okay? So the people will tell you a lot of complaints. And this patient has a lot of complaints. She cannot walk. She's got tired. And I have made some appointments. So you can write down what is important, the keynotes or the energetic words that the patient tells you. That's what I do in my private consultations. I note down what is strange, what is different. That's what is important for me, not ordinary complaints. We could think about cantharis for urinary complaints. So, but what is important for me? What is different in this person? So she says that nowadays she's starting to eat very fast, and usually she didn't do it. She used to eat slow, and she has breathlessness, and she does. In the consultation, always this she does always the this you think is lack of breath. I'm getting tired talking to you.
Is that not
So,
considered a, is that would not be looking up a sigh? That's not a sigh per se, the way she was doing it. It's sort of like gasping for air.
yes, gasping for air.
Okay.
Okay. So, in the consultation, she once in a while she stopped and did this. I don't have hair. So, even when she walks with her dog, she complains of lack of air and no energy whatsoever. We can go further, please. Another power problem. Go ahead, PowerPoint, okay? And she all this started at 15 years old. And she's starting having urinary loss. And from she now has 46. Since 15 years old, she 3 to 4 times daily she has to change the sanitary napkins. Can you imagine how uncomfortable this is for a woman? Okay, so the tiredness started at the age of 22. She could never play with her brothers and friends. Another PowerPoint. And the beauty of this is you can see at the age of 46 the transformation that this woman had. It's a beauty, and you can see in the follow-up. If you can manage to see the case, the full case, and the follow-up, you will see the change that this woman had. And this woman, and all cases, some cases that I have. Well, she also complains that when she finishes a book, she cannot remember what she has studied, blah, blah, blah. This is all stories for us. Not interest. Another PowerPoint. What is important is to let the patient talk. Do not interrupt. Let the patient tells us her story. Okay? Urinary problems. She never told anyone. I thought this was a woman thing. Only after visiting some naturopaths and acupuncturists, I realized that this was a problem. Even so, there was absolutely no treatment that helped her. And after this single dose, she mentioned that she is 100% cured and she now can walk, jump, whatever. But at this point, we are in the beginning of the consultation. Let the patient tell all story. Okay? That's what I have learned at the academy. So, if we can go further, please. I'm trying to read what you are writing. Okay, it's impossible to walk, to talk. Can you imagine now at 46, how am I will be at 60? Even my grandmother was 80s, and she walk 40 kilometers each day with no problem. Further?
Next slide. Right, so she seems to compare herself with
Yeah.
a timeline. She compares herself to say, I used to be like this and now I'm like this. She started off this way. And then also she's comparing herself to the other people in her family, her grandmother per se, that maybe she looked up to her grandmother or something, but that she is only 46 and she can't even keep up with her grand with or was it her grandmother? Yeah, with her grandmother's ability.
Yes, exactly. But what is important is that you see in front of you a woman that does not like herself.
Oh.
And in the follow-up, you see a woman that loves herself.
Oh.
That's a different, and you can see how she dresses in the follow-up. It's an amazing transformation of a person, not only on symptoms, but also in the personality. You see? So now the case begins. This must be 40 minutes now. I don't know, but for me, the case begins now. So the problem with the stairs is that it seems that I have lost this knowledge of walking. Okay, for me, this is, what is this knowledge? And I don't know where the peak is. This is strange. What the peak has to do with not having energy? Yes? Are you getting me?
Yes.
The peak is.
So all of a sudden there's kind of a shift in the conversation of what she's saying.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. She tells about peak. Where does this come from? Peak is something strange. So I note it down. What is peak? At the end, we can see that all will make sense to us, okay? Okay, so she now tells from nowhere, from nothing. It's like losing the ability to climb the mountain on some island. Where does this come from? Climbing the mountain on some island? This is strange for us, okay? Now we are stepping aside from allopathic medicine and we are going to magic medicine, special medicine.
It's okay to say magic.
No. Sorry. Not magic. It's scientific medicine, but it's amazing medicine. And what
Right.
we do to people, it's amazing. And science will need to prove this. Somehow, Einstein did it.
Guess when
That's
humans are amazed, then they think it's magic. They don't realize
okay,
how
but
it fits into the natural plan order of the universe.
course. Okay, but of course, exactly, I agree. So this is energy. This energy that is with all of us cannot be cannot it's only can it only can be transformed, cannot be destroyed or created, like Einstein's told us. Okay? This is our energy, and we are energy. Until now, nobody could prove the contrary, what Einstein told. Okay? So homeopathy is energy, and the energy is science, like Einstein told us. That's it. So the PowerPoint again, please.
We have a comment in the chat.
Okay.
Michelle is asking if you consider this type of case taking or finding the remedy, I guess, constitutional. And I'm not sure how you define classically what is the constitutional remedy or if you believe there is such a thing.
I think it's deeper than constitutional, it's energetic. It's our energy. We can talk about constitutional, like for example, phosphorus, sulfur. That's our polycrests. We can think about this kind of constitution. If we go to the Spanish, to the French school, they talk about the constitutional in a different way. They have the sulfuric constitution, the calcareous constitution, phosphoric constitution, the English and American and Indian ways. It's a little deeper. Any remedy can be constitutional. But what we do with this sensation approach is more energetic, constitutional. It's deeper. It's like the right remedy can touch your soul. If you get me.
Okay, I'll ask her if she liked this. Michelle says it sounds like a vital force transformation from receiving the proper constitutional simillimum. You want me to repeat that?
Yeah.
Michelle says that it sounds like a vital force transformation from receiving the proper constitutional similimum. So no?
No, not transformation. It's like your vital force has a resonance with the similar and it cures itself.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Okay. So it's just bringing out who you are rather than a transform. It's not changing you in any way. It's just enabling your soul energy to come out.
It's clearing you. Since we born until we die, the vital force, our energy is the same. But it can suffer some influences, diseases influences, family influences, job influences that makes we stay sick. That is the disease, as we call it. Okay? But the energy is always our energy or our vital force is always the same.
Uh-huh.
We can cure our energy when our vital force is in resonance with the same pattern, with the same energy. And that resonance can clear what we call the disease. Okay?
Okay. Dr. Bob is asking energy resonance of the remedies molecules? The energy.
Yeah.
Okay. Right? Okay. So it could be like a sound wave, whichever measurement it's, this is an energetic sphere, a pattern.
Yeah. I have, what we have seen at the other song, for example, there are people there, doctors, that don't really need to prescribe, don't really need to give a remedy.
Mm-hmm.
Just putting the patient in contact with this energy, with this resonance, they can be cured like that.
Like a magnet. Like a magnet, which Hahnemann talked a lot about magnetism in the organ. No,
perfect.
I mean, is that right? No?
Exactly.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. It harmonizes everything.
Okay. So, this is science. Wow.
we reached the moon. Okay.
Yeah. So I have a patient who told me once that, doctor, taking this remedy, it was like an homeopathic orgasm.
You have a lot of sexually oriented people in your clinic.
No. Not in that point of view, but this homeopathic orgasm, it was the climax.
The climax. Okay, so reaching the peak again.
She, in this case, it was he.
Okay.
This man never felt something like this before.
Right, so...
He's a nurse. So...
So it could be reaching this highest epitome of a wonderful thing or a release of this wonderful energy.
Yes. It was a release of the disease. He felt that.
Right.
The disease is gone.
Dr. Bob is asking, where does the resonance come from without the remedy? So how does how does the person get next to the resonance without having the remedy?
Okay. That will be a good team for a new seminar.
Okay.
But I can do a shortcut. For
okay.
example, what similar is when you go into hypnotherapy or a regression therapy. It's similar to that. For example, this case that I brought to you today, the patient gets into trance And she got contact with her energy, what she is. I don't know if she was cured by the remedy or this contact with herself. I don't know. I cannot. Nobody can explain what cured, because we don't have anything to measure the cure at certain point. I don't know if it was a remedy. Maybe it was. She told me yes, but I think she got in contact with her soul in the consultation. She got in the trance. Maybe if you want, I can tell you the remedy right now.
Well,
And
we can wait. We can wait. We'll go back to the slides in 1 second.
okay.
At the beginning of the show, I have every time a phrase, an affirmation. It says that you are wherever your thoughts are, and so when he says he's asking where does the resonance come from, if everything comes from spirit into mind, into intention, into voice, into action, through these different layers and levels. And if you can reach in your mind this vital force energy of being in the best place you can ever be, then you have touched the resonance. So it comes from within you, right? He's asking, if it's not in the remedy, in this little pill, how do I get it into me? But it's already in you. You just have to recognize it and be in touch with it. Is that right? Why
Yeah, I'm not saying that homeopathy is the only medicine. There are hundreds of science that can do this. Homeopathy is only one, another one. Okay? So I am seeing that, are we psychologists? No, we are holistics. At least we try to. I'm not saying that we cure everything. No. We try to cure, or we try to help people to cure themselves. And what we have is a remedy. Sensation method, or classical homeopathy, or Vitulka's method, it's all the same. It's homeopathy. Sensation method is only a process of case receiving or case taking, nothing more. We do the remedy. Of course, if the same patient comes to another homeopath, that homeopath can give a different remedy, and the patient can be cured too.
That's
I don't know why.
fascinating. Fascinating. Yeah. And I'm trying to remember the other sensation method practitioners who say that there are different similarities where, let's say, a plant, a mineral, or an animal remedy are so similar that they can be interchanged at different times in the person's life and still work wonders for the individual. So, I don't know whether you find this also.
I didn't get you.
I'm trying to remember we've had on the show previously other
Yes.
sensation met the Joshis. I think it's the Joshis. And
Yes.
they have a book that tells you sometimes the person is in need of a mineral, sometimes the same person is in need of an animal remedy, and sometimes a plant remedy, depending on at what point in their life they're at.
Depending on the state she is at the moment, yes.
Okay, so it's like you were saying something that sounded a little bit unusual that some people don't might not understand, where you can go to one homeopath and receive one remedy and it works, or go to another homeopath and receive a different remedy and that also works.
Exactly.
Okay.
Or
Just
you can go to another homeopath and he doesn't give you a remedy and you got cured. I have seen that
okay.
with my eyes.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, we're going to have to see that one happen. Okay, put that one on a video and then we'll know. Okay, so let's go back, and we're on slide number 14. This is the female doctor who is 46, and for those people just coming into the show now, and she's comparing the way she used to feel and the way she feels now, and she's going kind of like into a trance and explaining this.
So at this point, she's not in trance. She's starting to. She's not confused at this point. She's mixing the daily life with what she with images. Not in trance right now. She will be in trance later. And in trance, she'll be the real soul, the real source. You can see in the case in the video case, but let's go ahead. So she now says that she has. I have to go to the top to reach the mountain, and this is strange. I note it down. She tells about the parents controlling her life. She never had boyfriends or friends. Her parents were always with her. And we can go ahead, please.
We're at the plan, slide number 16.
Now at this point, what this PowerPoint is important for me, that because it tells me her miasma in our point of view. So she got this plan in the church, because at the church she was forced to marry with some guy that she didn't want to, and she took 4 years to plan something against her father and against the priest. So she did it. She did it. She got a plan to destroy his father. So this for me is quite syphilitic. Okay?
Can you
So we are at the present.
tell people why it is considered syphilitic?
Because you've seen the mean of the plan. She could destroy her father. Okay? If it was psychotic, she would hide something, hide herself, not destroying. You see the difference? The acute miasm, she will be in panic, complete in panic. Bah! I'm going to die now. What to do? Okay? Syphilitic, no. She plans for 4 years how to manage and how to destroy something. Okay? Psychotic will hide. Like the words. Okay? Tuya? We have to hide. I have to hide my words. That's psychotic. Okay? We can talk about that in another way, another time. Okay, let's go to the PowerPoint so our brothers and sisters see the case. I am uploading. It's 60 minutes left to upload. Okay, she now remembers that the urinary complaints exactly after this. And if you study psychology, you can understand that urinary complaints is something that you did wrong. Someone did something wrong. Okay? We can talk about that later. Okay, let's go to the PowerPoint.
Okay, we're on slide number 18, control.
Yes. She complains of being controlled all her life. She didn't want to get married. So she lived with her parents until 28. Then she decided to get married just to leave her parents home. Okay, this is only story for us, not important at this time. PowerPoint 19.
Right, it is up. It's up before you get to see it.
Yeah. This is the keynote of the remedy. When she talked, even before she got into the trance, with this PowerPoint, with this phrase she told, I already knew the remedy. She tells about that after the divorce, I needed freedom and to be on my own, to be free. Me and the stars, me and moonlight, I like the silence of the night. When she divorced, I had to buy a place, a flat, exactly on the top floor, where I can see and listen to the rain. So for me, free and freedom. I noted it down, and I knew the remedy. We can go ahead, please. And we will see at the end, everything will match. Everything will come together. And my question was, I think this was my second question of the case. The first one is, tell me about your problems. And the second is this one. How does it feel like this freedom? So my case receiving is to receive what patient has to say and ask exactly what they say. I don't change any word. The only thing I do is, how does it feel like this freedom? Freedom was what she said, into being on moonlight, the top of the floor, and now the case flows. We go ahead, please.
Queen of the mountain.
Yeah. And then she says, it's like being the queen of the mountain. I am in command position because I'm on the top. Now she is telling exactly the words and the characteristics of the remedy. She has power and vision and huge viewing angle. Freedom again. It's only me with freedom and liberty. Can you see how many times she tells about freedom? From the childhood, she had no freedom, and all the problems began, and she needs to be free. That's the key of the remedy, the keynote of this remedy. Let's go ahead, please. Tell just about air and freedom. I don't want to know about her life anymore, her problems, her complaints. I just want to know about freedom. And when I got a key note from any patient, I just tell him, please, I don't want to know nothing more. Just tell about this, in this case, freedom. It can be jail, it can be anything. At this moment, I don't want to know anything more. Imagine being there and flight. And what is the experience of flight, I asked? It is quiet, calm, free. When I'm on the porch of my house, I look around and then I do this gesture a lot, and then I can achieve flight. And then the patient gets into trance. We can see the rest of PowerPoints, but at this moment, can anyone tell me what mineral is this? That's my question. Is this a mineral, a plant, or an animal remedy?
Well, I mean, there are plants that have floating hamamelis. There are other ones that want to go up, minerals that want to go to the top of the mountain. Yes. There are
cannabis, for example. I have a lot of cannabis.
What is it?
Cannabis indica, for example.
Yeah, that's right. And it's a very healing remedy too.
Yeah, fantastic remedy. But the thing with cannabis, it's very sensible to outside. Okay? In this case, she tells a lot about her and the family, what the father made to her, what the husband made to her. There is a lot of conflict with another one, another people, okay? Cannabis has conflict with himself. You got it?
Okay.
I'm a Melidae family.
Right.
They are very sensible. They all have this flight feeling, the detaching of the body, but the conflict is with themselves. Okay? So
right.
The patient says that I have my meal. It's a victory sensation. Now she is in trance. You can see in the case taking that she is flying in front of me with eyes closed, just flying. She do all the movements to catching the meal, to going to the nest.
Did she say that?
No, she shows that.
Oh, she's showing you. Can you show us what she looked like with your gesture to kind of... Yeah.
You can, please. Okay, at this moment, please. I cannot see me.
Yeah, we see you.
Okay. The patient at this moment, she's in close eyes. You can see the movie. You can see the case on YouTube. I'm uploading it, okay? The patient is like this, doing this. No, there is a lot of silence during the consultation because she is into the source. She's flying, and my eyes, if you could see my eyes in front of her, I was like this. Oh my God, what is this?
Yeah.
Beautiful case, beautiful case. She even do this. When I go to the nest, I have to do this because I'm too cold. I have to recomfort myself.
Mm-hmm. So she did all the movements as if?
All the movements, all the source keynotes, the colors, what she wants to eat, what she looks like, and she, when she wake up, she told the remedy.
She did.
I didn't need to find it. So we can go direct to the PowerPoint with the remedy.
Okay. The next one we did.
I choose this remedy because I'm with my brothers and sisters from United States. Okay. So I choose the American Eagle.
Okay, we had somebody in the chat say the falcon.
No, the falcon has speed.
Okay.
The theme of the falcon is there is speed, and I have to complete a job and come back to my owner. Okay? The eagle team, if you think about Nelson Mandela, this is his remedy, freedom. The freedom of his people, the freedom of his himself from jail.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And so
Falcon is more speed?
The speed, and also the falcon has more praise.
What do you mean?
Praise.
Predators. Prey on the other animal.
Yes,
okay.
In this kind of eagle only has one predator, and she tells about it in the case.
Okay, so shall we go to slide number 26, the four-month follow-up?
20-something, the eagle first?
The eagle comes after. Yes.
Okay,
so slide number 26 says the four-month follow-up, that she
okay.
still has tiredness, but not as much as before. When climbing the stairs, she does not have it, the loss of ability anymore, and her urinary loss is completely gone. Slide number 26, yeah. And she can jump, she's more secure. Another thing is that she feels differently about men. At least she says, I am now available to get a partner. And in the Eagle family, they are partners for life, are they not? Okay, so then we have the slide about the, here's a quote from Robert Greene Ingersoll. It says, a believer is a bird in a cage. A free thinker is an eagle parting the clouds with tireless wing. So that poem comes from this author, all about the bald eagle. And the next one is the picture of the American eagle you see in flight with wings expanded in this posture above the mountains, high up in the sky. And then we have the American eagle. Did you want to make a comment? I'm taking over.
You are doing great, Debbie. Thank you.
Okay, so then the next one we have the very, this one kind of, how do you express this expression? How do you, it's
serious.
Serious, yeah, like the judge or something, I don't know. In front of the American flag, waving in the background.
This slide was for you. I brought this case just for you because I have a lot of animals, plants, minerals, but I choose this one for you.
Yes. Okay.
Beautiful, beautiful remedy.
All right. So now we're up to learning a little bit more about this particular remedy and all of the things that people would want to know so they recognize it.
Okay, it was a 10-apothecy, one single dose, no repetition.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Potency 10M, one time, one dose only. Okay. And so we have, it's the animal kingdom, it's a bird remedy, and we have the name. So if you want to order it from the pharmacy, you have to ask for Haliatus leucocephalus.
Yeah, yes.
Okay. Now we have the theme. So if you feel the patient speaking about these particular themes, you're kind of looking for something in the bird category. And have you had other kind of birds like wrens and robins and chickadees and things like that?
For example, if you have a pigeon.
Okay.
A pigeon. Columbus, it's a remedy. He will talk about message all the time. I have to give the message. I have to take the message somewhere else and bring the message back.
Oh.
And he is quite fast, like Falcon. But the main theme is message. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Okay. So we might be thinking of things, communication, phosphorus, or something else.
Yeah, but if you go deep into the patient, if you have a phosphorus, you will have the mineral exactly in your front. If you have a bird, you will see. He will talk about earth, flying, being free, sky, floating. The phosphorus will have much more anxiety about his friends, about sympathy.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite different. It's on the right side of the periodical table. It's a little unstable somehow. Okay?
Okay.
There is no, he will not talk about liberty, freedom.
Okay.
He needs to be surrounded by friends. Okay?
Okay.
The minerals are like that. They need to be surrounded, or they are lacking something, or they don't want it. They want to be free of that people, of that job, of that situation. Okay? It's more, he will talk more about family, job, troubles. The minerals are like that.
Okay. And also, it says this, the idea of a cage is very, very close to birds. What's the king that used to have the bird that sang in it? What kind of a the songbird? I don't remember the name of the bird, but you always think of birds in cages. And as domesticated as we try to make them, I don't think you can ever make them domesticated, can you?
What remedies?
Birds. Can you ever like a dog? You can domesticate a dog, and they can be your best friend, or they can live close to you. But a bird, can you? Well, I guess parrots you can.
All birds will talk about
Mockingbird, thank you. Okay.
not being free.
Not being free.
That's their main issue. Is that they are in cage, or they have a job to do, or they have a owner. But their nature is to be free, it's to fly.
Right.
The chicken cannot fly. So the trouble with the chicken is that she wants to fly, but she cannot fly.
I love chickens. That's my favorite.
That's like having the wings cut.
Yeah. But they are wonderful pets.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yes, I love chickens. Okay, so we're on slide number. We don't have a slide number here. Okay, so torture, abuse, humiliation, desire to go to high places, which she mentioned a lot, going to the peak. Connections to the mountains she mentioned, but I don't recall if she talked about the sea. So both the sea and the mountains.
Yes, she talks about the sea, and when she goes to the prey, she fishes the prey, the
Aha.
fish. She do
Right.
that gesture. I have to go there and catch the fish.
Have you ever seen the videos of the birds that dive under the water? They're like a bullet. They're like an arrow that goes straight down, and they go underneath, and they're swimming. They get it, and they come up.
Seabirds,
Wow. And they travel in groups. So there are some birds that are singular, like to be alone. I guess like this, the eagle. And then there's some that have, well, the migrating birds, they're all in flocks and they have formation. So is that here? Yes, travel and migration. And you have horizon. What do you mean, horizon?
Travel and migration. She did go to Germany.
We have attractiveness and dancing, so there are birds that do attract each other with a special dance. And they might talk about that aspect of their character. And then we have this I'm not sure I understand, expansion and separated from the world. How does that fit in with the birds?
Eagles are spiritual, right? And they in mythology, they are messengers from the other world.
Oh.
Indians, they venerate the eagle. The eagle are they is their god. Because they are messaging from this world to the other world. They are spiritual birds, spiritual animals.
I see. Right, and we use their feathers in their dancing, in the populations on the of the in American Indians on the reservations.
Exactly.
Prior to being caged, the American Indian and removed from their land, they use the feathers and the headdresses and everything.
Yes, the eagle is the most evoluted bird.
Really? I think Benjamin Franklin liked the turkey. Benjamin Franklin wanted the American symbol to be the turkey, and
Why?
Because he said it was the smartest bird, although I don't think that's correct, because they will, if I recall, my husband telling me that they will go out in the rain and drown because they will. But I'm trying to think, what would be the smartest bird? I don't know. I think about parrots, and I don't
The
know.
smartest bird, good question. For me, is the eagle.
Really? Okay. I don't know. We'll have to investigate this one. If anybody has any ideas, send us a message via pigeon. Okay. Okay, you have an out-of-body experience, so that would feel kind of like the Hamamelis. And now we're going to hunt, chase, power, soaring, and high, which we kind of heard. And I guess their beaks would be the implement of, and their talons would be sharp, cutting, tearing, and splitting, hooked beaks and claws, trap, caught, suffocated, and break free. So that is kind of like a tuberculin miasm, but also it's not only describing, it's describing the victim of the prey, as well as maybe what they could feel. Both sides, is that correct?
Yes.
Right, because they will prey, they're hunters, and they will trap, catch, and bring up their prey and cut off their breath.
Yeah, they
But
will kill.
yeah. Okay, torture. So you see this kind of element of torture. Would you see
So,
this element in the plant or the animal? I mean, or the
yeah.
plant or the mineral, this torture?
And healers and therapists.
What is it?
Healers,
Yeah. Oh.
therapists,
Oh.
homeopaths, you see?
Yeah.
We all eagle eyes.
Okay.
I'm just joking. I'm just joking.
Well, I don't know if we want to help other people to be free. I don't know if yeah, they're supportive of other people. There's lots of energy, but it is blocked in the body. How do you explain, can you explain that a little bit more?
They have in their extensive, they have a lot of energy, as the patients say, but at one, but they cannot walk straight. They can they are good flyers, but they are not good walkers.
Ah.
So they have this sensation and feeling of cannot walk straight. It's like my legs are blocked. They only complains of problems in the legs.
I'm thinking about a penguin. Is a penguin a bird? Is considered a bird?
Yeah.
Yeah, a penguin. So a bird, a pe he's out of his element when he's on the land. He has a difficulty, but in the water, he's totally free.
He flies in the water, that's the difference.
Those are very unique animals.
Beautiful animal, beautiful.
Have you ever had a patient who needed the penguin?
No, not yet.
Not yet. We will
But
ask.
a lot of snakes, my God.
Oh my goodness gracious. Okay, next time you'll tell us the snake story. Okay, freedom, easygoing, light, freedom of movement and expression. Trapped is next. Trapped, so these are sort of the opposite ends, the trapped and the freedom. And trapped also by duty and obligation, by responsibility. Dependence and independence. There's a feeling of dependence on the family, which alternates with the natural desire to be free. So, does the individual stay to fulfill the obligation, or do they release themselves and go off on their own? I don't know whether what is the best state for the for this energy to be.
No, there is no best state. There's this a natural thing. They have to go to the neck. Okay? They have the sons there in the neck. So the eagle and almost all birds will talk about their duties in coming to the family. They have to protect the family.
Okay, so protection is important, and their connection to their loved ones is most important, even though they have a desire to be free.
Yes, and once they are grown, they have to go out of the neck and find a new home.
Out of the nest.
The nest, yes, sorry,
Oh,
the nest.
okay. There is an amount of freedom, but there is a need to come back to the duties, which is a huge conflict in this remedy, feeling trapped by their dependence and wanting to be independent. In the provings, some of the aspects that were brought out on the next slide is free, carefree, speed, flying, giggling, and innocence. That's an interesting one. Empathy for people or nature, feeling scorned or humiliated, having confidence or perhaps lack of confidence, anger, coldness, and detached. Some more provings. There's a relationship between the birds and the horses, and you think of Pegasus on that. Delusions, spirals. That's, oh, I guess if they spiral down on the air currents.
Exactly, yes.
Disgust with herself, which you think about, is that Thuya is like that also? Ecstasy, sublime for nature, dreams of kites. Oh, how many kites have you seen that have birds' pictures on them? A lot of them. Forsaken feeling, weeping, tearful mood in open air. Open air aggravates, rather? Would the open air aggravate or make them feel better?
We're talking about provings.
Okay, that's in the provings. And then another proving symptoms, birds live in a different medium. They're eating a lot and they have a fast metabolism. Also, you think of their bones as being light. Vision, very good vision. Some of them have night vision like the owl, so they're nocturnal. Music. So music, you think of typically Nature Muriaticum or sepia, ocean animals. So here we can think of music also connection for birds.
The provings
Oh,
of music, the
yeah.
music is more spiritual music in
Ah.
this kind of proving.
Okay. That's very interesting. Okay, so more on the provings connection, understand the person's feelings. So these are when okay, it maybe to explain to people what is it that's in the provings that's different from doing an actual clinical case and getting the remedy and understanding?
In provings,
Yeah.
when you do a proving, you can have a lot of different situations belonging to this, with the same issue, or rather you can have aggravated in open air, or amelioration in open air. I don't think it's quite relevant the rubrics here, the aggravation, because in provings you can have anything, you know, aggravation in upper air, but you can also be ameliorated. The patient talks about aggravated in open air, in her state, in her human state, right? But when she, but what she is as energy is that she likes to be in open air. So you have a duality. This can be disease, in my understanding.
Can you go a little bit more? The duality is part of the disease.
For example, if the patient, in this case, the patient talks about cannot walk against the wind. Okay? This is disease state. But as a bird, she likes to be flying with the wind. Okay? So what we have is, as disease, the patient cannot, as human, cannot walk against the air. But her energy ameliorates with air. So when you do a proving, we cannot say if it's the disease or it's the energy. You can only count it for rubrics. Okay? If you put a rubric aggravating from aggravating from wind, because the patient has this complaint. Okay? And you will have a lot of remedies, and the eagle is there. But that does not mean that the source or the remedy in himself aggravates with wind. It's only a clue. The rubrics are only clues and only symptoms.
So over time, we would understand a little bit more what is actually a remedy that would be go into the repertory. With the provings, it's just we have to gather more energy, more information from more people who do more provings to see what is actually the highest that works the most, or is just part of the person rather than part of the proving. So then on slide number 40, we have the 4 month follow-up. Somehow I put that in here. And she says she doesn't like, she didn't like coats. Did she really say she didn't like coats at all? But then she likes them?
Yeah, no, because you will see on the follow-up that it is very funny that she comes in red and white, exactly like an eagle, and the coat she is wearing is white, and she feels so great, so beautiful. It's a completely different woman.
Well, we will definitely see it once it's up. We will redirect everybody where to find it on the YouTube. And I want to thank you. We've come to the end of the program, and I have a couple of announcements to make. I want to thank you so much for doing this on the fly, I got to say. Just finding out about being on the show last night and putting this whole thing together on. We are just grateful that you're here and you've given us so much to think about and to learn. I want to thank Amnon for being his best.
Thank you.
And to everybody who came in to listen, and remember that I'm getting a message from friends elsewhere who have not even gotten onto the chat that they really, really enjoyed the program today, what you taught. And please do send me more feedback from the listeners. We love you all. And I have here a quote. If you are really thankful, what do? You share. So that's not my idea. That's W. Clement Stone. So he probably would be great on social networking today. I've got a couple of items that I'd like to share with you on slide number 42. I've been taking the sufficiency green tea drink. I think Amnon has been too regularly. We just love the taste, and it's a high vitamin C, and the green tea is great for you. And I want to make a big announcement that the Complete Dynamics program, which you can learn more about on Homeopathy World Community website or the website completedynamics.com, they're going to be raising their prices for the first time in 5 years. So this is your opportunity now before January 1st, 2015, coming up to the new year, to get this program on the price that it's been for 5 years, and then it's going to go up around about 15%. So there's going to be an increase in that. The next slide is talking about the Narayana publishers, and we have a link from Homeopathy World Community to a number of fantastic books. Many of the Sensation Method books and everything you can find, bird books and everything else, when you go to Homeopathy World Community and click on that little link, one of the things that they're showing right now is this cancer compendium, Specter of Homeopathy with Dr. Manfred Mueller, and many of the other homeopaths who you know and love have articles there about cancer and curing cancer using homeopathy. And the last slide here, slide number 44, on February 16th, oops, I think it's supposed to be 2015. Pardon my error. I'm still in this year. Fran Sheffield, of the UK, of no, she's in Australia, I think. The differences in approaches to the treatment of autism, classical Seath's method, sequential, and learning about their strengths and limitations. So she's offered to talk about that, Or would you like to learn about the pressures of that homeopaths face in today's political environment? As you know, she has had been sued, a court case against her, for practicing homeopathy and talking about vaccinations and how all of these autistic children are getting healed with homeopathy. So this is it's still ongoing. It's very controversial. So tell us, which one would you rather hear about? On slide number 45, we have, go to the archives to see, what are we, 3 years worth of programming at least. 3 to 4 years of programming, fantastic shows and educational about homeopathy and just in general health, the environment, everything. So I want to thank you again, Dr. Carlos, for being with us, for sharing your education and your experience. And we want to wish you well. I hope you're feeling good. I know you've been through a lot lately, and so have I. Our health is most important, so I know that we have to take care of ourselves in the best way we can. That is one of the reasons why I've dropped out of the airwaves. I haven't been doing shows for a while now, and hopefully I'll do maybe once a month. If anybody has any ideas for guests that we should have on in 2015, please send me a message. And do you want to say anything else? We have a few more minutes before we close.
Just thanking you, Debbie.
And I thank you.
To all of you.
Yes. Hugs, kisses, lots of love, lots of energy. We both gather the energy into ourselves and we send it out. Do we have somebody talking to us? Okay, okay. You will send us the link to the YouTube of this particular case when it is totally finished upload, and we will put it onto the announcement page on Homeopathy World Community. Great, I know. It's, you know what, we deal with frustrations and blocks and, you know, all of these things that cause us to have a traffic jam or not get what we expect it to be, but we always come through completely whole and in good spirits. So I want to thank all of those who have been with us today. Judith, Dr. Sharma in New Delhi, and Michelle in Arizona. Connie, I don't know where you're from. You could put it in there. And since it's going to be archived, people can come and watch later.
And the other
1,135 people. 1,135 people? Woo! Okay, we got a lot of listeners today. I want to thank everybody who's out there. Please go out for a walk. Take in the air. Have a beautiful day. And we're going to have another show. Amnon is producing another show at 1. Oh, for me?
Oh, today.
Today at 1 o'clock, is it? At 1 o'clock with Marilyn Shannon. I don't know what she's going to be doing. Thank you, Michelle, for the compliments. Hopefully, we will be getting better and better every day. And that's one of the mantras you can say to yourself. If you'd like to come back again, Dr. Carlos, let me know. And if there's another topic, we'll be prepared a lot earlier. Okay?
Bye.
Okay, bye-bye now. Bye-bye, everyone.
Tune to the Nissan Communications Network. Our weekly lineup of call-in programs includes Computers 2K Now with Amnon Nissan, Health In with Debbie Brooke, Breaking Free with Marilyn Shannon, Lessons of Vietnam with NCBVI members, The Tanya Love Show, Your Healthy Pet with Gisela DiCarlo, And if you tuned in too late, you can always watch each program in its entirety or download an MP3 audio file of it at www.nissancommunications.com. Sponsored by Atomos.com, makers of quality video recorders and converters for professionals. CarolinaApparel.com and DeltaForce.net.